The more I look at it, the more I hate it. A lot of you people said, don't touch it. But I just can't help it. I just need to see if this part is actually worth removing, if it weighs a lot. I reckon each one would be at least 1.5 kilos on each side. So that's 3 kilos. The reason why I want to remove it. One. This used to serve to hold the original seatbelts for the rear passengers. We don't have rear passengers, clearly. So all of those, they have really thick reinforcements in here, specifically here and here at the bottom. So I don't see why we need this. A lot of people said, don't touch it, it will change the integrity of your thing because it's structural. Well, structural, yes and no. I mean, we have roll cage that is mounted and tied into the suspension points. So effectively, this part of the thing is irrelevant. It doesn't really do much. The only thing it does, and that's my main concern, is that my wing is actually attached to this corner. But we're not removing everything, we're just removing the inner part. So this being folded in like 3 places, this will be plenty strong. But also what I think I will do, I'll weigh this. And if I can remove, let's say, okay, let's be 2.5 kilos from both sides, then what I will do is I will add another support bar, probably from carbon fiber, titting, which will actually bolt at the bottom, because if you can see, I have 3 nuts and bolts. So I will extend that plate. So from there, it will literally go onto the cage. So we will effectively tie in the wing like it's supposed to be to the chassis, which is now the roll cage, which is actually attached to the top strut mount instead of actually just being mounted onto the body itself. So one of them, you know, the bottom lower is the actuator that is attached to the roll cage. And the top one that will be attached here sort of diagonally. This will give us a bit more strength, but also we'll be able to remove all of this. It's unnecessary, it's ugly, and I just need to see how much weight this is. I reckon it will be weighty, so let's get the grinder out.
That's a good one.
By the way, about 75% of you guys are not subscribed to my channel. Why not? Just hit that subscribe button now and that little bell icon as well so you don't miss any future content. So we've removed quite a bit. It's actually 2.5 kilos of dead weight, as I call it. But the main reason why I was doing that is because, as you know, my wing has always been attached to C D pillar. I don't know. I wasn't really 100% happy with it because it's supposed to be attached to the chassis. So by removing all that, we can actually add something else. Those are supports that I've been thinking about for quite a long time, how to actually mount the wing directly to the chassis. And those things actually mount. That's where the top bracket of the wing is attached to, like this. So you can see what's doing it. Yep. Let me. So each one of them, by the way, they're only 410 grams. I mean, it's pretty light, so it's not like we're adding a ton of weight. We removed 2.4, adding only 800. It's going to be welded right onto the cage where I have my actuator. So, and it gets bolted through here. So, in essence, we have a wing that is going to be supported by the rod. Now I just need to weld it in here, just sort of nicely around, just to, and over here, and that should give us the strength and support for the wing that we want. And then we will continue with our quest of removing weight, adding something lighter, and building the fastest one. Yeah. We are painted. That's only a zinc primer thing, even though you can't really tell the difference, can you? Yeah, that's the beauty of battleship gray Nardo thing. We'll be painted so too much everything else, but race car, even like this, is fine. Extremely happy how it turned out. It looks sick blood. I don't know why I'm talking about this. Yeah, it's basically, it's not going anywhere. I'm not sure what the next step is. Let's have a look.